Looks like it's going to be a wet, stormy night. I'm better off heading into the woodland for some shelter. Maybe somewhere on the lee of the woodland, maybe. Out of the wind. I don't fancy being under this, or any of these tall ash trees. If the wind picks up, they're forecasting heavy rain and strong winds tonight. I want somewhere safe.
This looks alright. I think I'll pitch up here.
Well, that looks nice and symmetrical. That's just what I want. It should give me a perfect pitch. Well, that's me, safely installed in my tent. I'm in the Luxe Hexpeak. I've not used it for some time, but I thought I'd give it a try because it's got a lot more room than the other little teepee that I sometimes use in the woods. It's got a lot less weight, just more practical solution, I think, to this sort of camping. Also, I took the chance and recently weather sealed it, and so I was pleased to know that the water was beading up nicely on the outside, so it'll be a good test of it tonight. The forecast is for horrendous wind and rain. The main rain should be hitting in about an hour's time. It's now 6:15 in the evening, so I'll be getting my food on in a minute. So that's the shelter. Pitching it, once you've got the knack of it, basically the thing is to get it symmetrical. When you lay it out, you just get it symmetrical, and provided you've got it symmetrical, it goes up perfect. So I'm really happy with it. Anyway, nightfall is happening. It's getting dark out there. It'll be soon time to hunker down. Rab 700 in the nest in here. This is called the nest. So I'll be comfortable in here. I think it's a good idea always when camping in the woods to have some sort of inner to keep the bugs away, because there's some nasty insects out there. Namely ticks, etc. You don't want to get bitten by any of them. So that's the reason why I've put the nest up. But also it keeps it a couple of degrees warmer as well. Anyway, for my meal this evening, I got the ubiquitous piece of steak, and I got some vegetables which are supposed to be oven roasted, but I'll be frying them in and a pan, I think. So we'll see how it goes. Brought a couple of stoves with me to try. Looking forward to a really relaxing night, and the sound of the rain gonna be awesome. I'm really looking forward to this. Bit of therapy. Sorry, you're up there. I'm looking at the light. Bit of therapy. I need therapy. Have a look out the door. It is really getting dark and quite stormy out there. I thought I'd try this multi-fuel Optimus stove. Optimus of Sweden. I can't remember the make of the stove. What I'll do, I'll stick it in the description box, I think. But it's a multi-fuel stove. You've got to pump the fuel up. I got paraffin in there, I think. But it doesn't matter what fuel you've got. You can have petrol or paraffin or diesel. It's the same jet. And you can even mix the fuel, I believe. So anyway, that's what I'm going to be using as my stove tonight. I've also got, I bought this Transia Mini. I've never used this stove. Main reason being because I saw one being used and it was very tippy, and I thought, well, I don't think I'll use it. But in actual fact, it will be quite a practical little stove if you can get a nice level surface. So I will use it at some point. I may use it tomorrow morning for a cup of coffee or something, we'll see. Anyway, let's get the stove assembled and start cooking the meal. The stove's going through its ignition warm-up phase at the moment, so you've got to allow a little bit of fuel to come through into a little preheating area, and then you ignite that and it preheats the burner. And then once it gets hot enough, it vaporizes the fuel and you get a lovely blue controllable flame. This would be a fantastic stove for the winter time. So another good reason to bring it out now and start the practice with it, because I'll be using it a lot, I think, in the colder weather. It's almost ready to go. It's still burning with that yellow flame. So I'll just turn the valve on and off until it goes blue. Now it's starting to vaporise. I can hear it. My vegetables, they're meant to be put in an oven and roasted, but I'm going to put them in the pan. They've got oil on them already, but I'll put a bit more coconut oil on them, I think. Meanwhile, the steak is cooking nicely, so I'll let it cook a bit longer, and then I'll put this on the burner and put that lid on the top with the steak on it. Hopefully that'll keep the steak nice and warm for me. Then I can eat my vegetables and my steak together. Well, there it is. Don't know if you can see it very well. There's my steak and my vegetables. And I got a lovely can of San Miguel. So the rain's just started to come down now. I think it's going to be a beautiful camp, this. I've got a feeling. Good feeling it's going to be a good one. Anyway, I'm going to sit down, I'm going to relax, I'm going to enjoy my food. I'm going to tidy everything away, get it all squared away for the morning. I'm going to get in my sleeping bag and maybe watch a bit of YouTube or something on the phone. And I'm just going to chill out and I'm going to relax. I'm just going to soak in the vibes of the woods and the rain. That's good. Maybe you can hear the rain. Food was lovely, went down very well. I think the rain has intensified in the last quarter of an hour. Now from the San Miguel. Oh, very refreshing. Well, I didn't mention it earlier. I did cycle in to the woods and I've had to walk, park the bike up. And I've been very careful to cover the bike over and hide the bike away. And I've had to walk the rest of the way to the location where I'm at now. It's not too far, only a few hundred yards, but it wasn't worth pushing the bike through all the undergrowth to get here. So hopefully the bike will be safe in the morning, covered over, it should be nice and dry, and then I can cycle the 3 mile journey back home again in the morning. I tend to do a bit more cycling in the winter months because it keeps you warm. Motorcycles, people that are subscribed for the motorcycles, I've got two motorcycles, I've got the V-Strom and the Royal Enfield Himalayan. I've sawned the V-Strom, that's a statement of off-road notification for those that aren't in the UK. That's been taken off the road and I'll retax that when the better weather comes, probably next year now I expect. But the Enfield I'll keep on the road all year round. And provided the weather stays nice, I might even be able to fit in one more moto camp. I might get another week or two of fine weather before the real sort of winter sets in. So if it does stay nice, I could be heading off back to Wales again. We'll have to see. Anyway, listen to the rain. Lovely. I doubt you can see much now, got the light dimmed down. I'm in my sleeping bag, I think I'm going to turn in, get my head down, just listen to the rain. It's been pretty non-stop. It's going a bit quieter at the moment, but earlier on it was really, I guess I've heard the northerners use this term, it was lagging it down. Anyway, I'm going to get my head down now. Unless anything happens or whatever, I'll probably see you in the morning. So good night. Well, this is that other stove I mentioned yesterday, or last night rather. It's a Transgen Mini. I've got a very small leak in my tent. It's leaking from a seam. Anyway, it's not a problem, it's not leaking onto me. It's a Transgen Mini. It's brand new. Look at that, look. Never been used. So I thought I'd use it this morning to get me a morning coffee. I was given some of these barista sort of coffee brewers. So you open the top up, you pour the water in, let it brew, then undo the side thing and you pour your water, pour your freshly brewed coffee out. So I'm going to give that a try as well. First of all, let's get the little burner going. First time. Brand new Transgen burner. I reckon that'll be hot enough now. Steaming.
I don't know if you can see it on that camera, but there's a little scale on the side here. And the level, you see where the level is. Just above the strong. So that'll make 2 cups of strong coffee. That should get me kick-started anyway.
As the old hymn goes, after the rain, the sun. Beautiful morning out here, absolutely glorious. And look, there's the sun.